What we are talking about is less about Islam or Muslims, but about identity and ideology in a globalizing world. In fact, I would suggest that most of the talk about Muslims in our midst has less to do with Islam, or worse, the threat of Islam, and much more to do with tensions within specific societies. Much of the talk today about Islam is really about local and regional problems. European identity, for example, is premised more and more on not being Muslim. In other words, through Islam, some Europeans find ways not just to label others, but more profoundly to define themselves in opposition to those others, in opposition to the Muslims in their midst. Hence, not only must the black man be black, he must be black in relation to the white man.
This is the question: how inclusive do our respective nation states in Europe, and maybe also here in the US, define their national identity, or how exclusive? I think it's not a problem to say I am this or that, because every definition also and every construction of identity always deals with the question of who am I not. Mm-hmm. That's not the problem. The problem is when we come to the point and say who I'm not and I don't want the other. Mm-hmm. That's the problem.
Actually, my first experience of being a foreign photographer in a conflict zone was in Jerusalem, when I went to photograph the beginning of Second Intifada. And when I was entering into Al-Aqsa, or Dome of the Rock, I was stopped simultaneously by Palestinian guard and Israeli soldier, who said, no, this is just for Muslims. And I was, dressed pretty much like this, and they said, yeah, but I'm Muslim, but unfortunately, from my name, you can't really understand if I am, nor I have any physical, and that was the point. I don't have any physical resemblance to the usual stereotypes of Muslims. But what struck me is that all of a sudden the fierce enemies, the Israelis and the Palestinians, share this, you're not part of it, you're out. And actually, then they actually made me quote a few things from Quran, mm-hmm. only a few that I know. As some sort of login and password, and it worked out, and they let me in. But it was like that. But that made me really believe that somehow this issue of color and race somehow even goes beyond the religious or ethnic or religious affiliation.
There are many cultures, many diversity within Islam world. You can see it in Poland. Mm-hmm. This mosque is, the architecture is like Saudi Arabia, style of mosques, mm-hmm. and you have different Muslims living, there. There was a very nice incident in 9/11 when the mosque in Gdańsk started to be attacked by some Polish, right-wing groups and so on. Jewish people living in Gdańsk offered to guard the mosque at that very moment.
But they are what you would call Arab youth in Denmark. They have a very strong youth culture, and they've actually dragged some white kids over. Mm-hmm. So they're making their own kind of integration, being completely unable to be a part of the Danish society. They've sort of made their own culture. Mm-hmm. And I see that as a very creative, fun, life-affirming sort of thing.
I live in Holland for some years, and over there, in general, in Europe, it's very easy to spot, like, the Muslim neighborhood. You see like thousands of satellite dishes on top of the building. And that's pretty much like, indication of some very isolated community, some kind of ghetto within mm-hmm. within any single town in Europe.
Mm-hmm. Hey, wallah! Moja husana blu chichel integralite! Disko yoste apli!
Integral? Er det ikke noget med high schoolen?
Nej, det er rigtig nok, hvad alle siger. Alle de integrale kisler, de er chichel glade friske. Jeg tror, det vil klæde jer tre rigtig godt at lave noget integration med hinanden.